So we're about a week away from launching AccountEdge Pro version 2015, and I thought I'd show you what we're working on. All right, so let's show you a couple of the features that are coming out next week. And where do we start? Let's go with sales, and I'll create a new sale. And you'll notice here, let's sell a blade grinder. You'll notice here that there's that new icon right here that indicates that a commission was being calculated on this sale. So AccountEdge Pro now calculates commissions, and they're also paid through payroll. But you don't necessarily need to use our payroll. You can run reports to get these calculations and use them in whatever payroll system you choose. So if we go to the list menu, and under sales and purchase information, commission rate levels, you'll see I have all my rate levels. I created one called Tom's Commission, and in this case, it's a custom rate level. So depending on the item that's sold, so this one gets a 2% commission, this one's just a dollar when sold, and this one has a 10% based on its margin. You can set up a fixed percent or a dollar amount just flat across the board. And in this case, this one is set up to be earned when it's fully paid versus when the sale is actually recorded. So I'm going to change this to be upon sale. I'll click OK. And we go back and let's choose Charles because he's a good example. And we'll look at, we'll click that icon. And you'll see that the calculation is right here. So the 2%. On this particular line, and this was a $1 amount for that commission. And you can see that it's already earned. Now, if we were to create a new sale for someone that isn't commissionable, maybe Hana, you'll notice the icon's different. So in this case, I can apply a commission level. We'll use Tom again, and it will show you the commission. And there's no commission being paid yet because it hasn't been earned because it's not recorded yet. So we'll cancel out of here. And you'll see there's on the desktop, we have a salesperson commissions, and that will take you to a window where you can choose your salesperson, let's say Charles, and we can see all the commissionable sales that are available to him. And if I'm not using AccountEdge payroll, I can select them and mark them as paid. Now, if we go over to payroll, actually, let's go over and look at that employee card. Let's say an employee, and we look at Charles. Here, I can set the commission rate level, and under payroll details, under wages, you'll notice that I have his wage for commission set up as commissions. Now, if I take a look at a vendor, you might actually have salespeople that are contracted vendors, and in this case, I can look at alternative beverages under card details, and I have this checkbox that says that this is a commissionable salesperson. What this box does is it will add this vendor to the salesperson's list, which is a nice little feature on its own. But once that's checked, you can now select a commission rate level, and then you can run reports to see the amount of commissions that were earned for this particular vendor to cut them a check manually. But if we go over to payroll and we do this really quick, so we'll put in Charles, and you'll see that we can either add commissions in his regular pay run or as a separate commission check. We'll use the regular pay run for now, and I want to include commissions in this paycheck, and it'll pull commissions that were earned between these date ranges here, and we'll choose next. We'll drill into this payroll paycheck, and you'll see commissions. I can drill down, and I can see a list of all the commissions, and I can drill further into the actual sale if I need to make any changes. But they all look good. I'm going to choose OK, and then we can go ahead and pay that straight through payroll, which is great. Now, let's see. What else can we show you? Oh, yeah. So let me get out of here, and I'll go over to inventory. We'll take a look at the items list, and I have an item here. You'll notice that we track serial numbers now for AccountEdge. And once this is checked, I go over to the serial numbers tab, and from here I can see all the serial numbers associated with this item, and if they were bought, if they were sold, who they were sold to, who they were bought from. And you can also set this up so it applies a warranty when they're sold. In this case, it's 365 days, and I can see when that warranty expires. Along with this are reports that'll provide you with warranty expirations, so you can take a look at whose warranty is expiring, as well as who owns which serial numbers. So that's a cool feature, and I'll show you how that works. If you go through purchases, you can actually buy them, and I don't necessarily need to show you that, but we'll show you how they're sold. Let's pick two, and it was the item called item serialized. You'll notice this icon, choose that. And from here, I can select the serial numbers that I want to sell. But let's say I didn't enter them in while I purchased them, but they're printed right on the boxes that I'm about to sell. So I can select new, and then we'll choose, I don't know, let's say N1, and we need to create two of them because that's the amount we're selling. We choose create, it selects them, and then they're sold. And we can just record those. So that's great. Let's see, what else can I show you here? Just a couple of minor things. Let's see, under cards list, this one was asked for by a bunch of customers and a couple of our partners. They want the ability to hide inactive cards. So you'll see this checkbox here. And when I choose that, it will hide the inactive cards. And that's really helpful if you have a pretty big card file and you've been using the inactive, make inactive, market inactive feature. And this is actually available on the cards list, the items list, jobs list, and a couple other places. So that's great. We've also made changes to 1099s. So we take a look, where's that? Purchases, print 1099s. And I don't have a lot to work with here, but if I select these, you'll notice that we're now counting up the number that are selected and the number of payments that have been selected. This is really helpful, not in this case, because I only have two. If you're dealing with 100 1099s, this will be pretty helpful to see actually which ones are selected. Now, if we go up to the top, you can see categories. We can now filter by the type of category, so attorney fees or rents, royalties, or other income. And we'll go ahead and just choose all. And you select these, and then when you go ahead and print your 1099s, it's going to save these settings for when you go to print your 1096. One other thing I should mention, if you go to advanced filters, you can now also sort by the amounts. So I might only want to print 1099s for those vendors that I've made payments to for over $600. Now, along with that, if we go to reports, there's a report down here, 1099. Final information report that will show all the details of the 1099s that you've actually printed. Okay, one last thing. If we go to sales and we take a look at a line item, so let's say we're going to sell a blade grinder again, and if you go to the jobs field, you'll notice that we can now split a line across multiple jobs. So in this case, I want to split it between these two jobs. And let's say it's $25 here and only $10 there. So I can split that up. It doesn't have to be the full allocation. We can just split up any amount we like. And then same with percentages. I can just make this 50% and the other one 50%, and we'll use the full amount and choose OK. And you can do the same thing in departments. So you'll be able to use percent or amount in the department fields. And one last thing, if you have a Shopify store and you're using AccountEdge to link to Shopify, which is a great way to sell products online, we now let you allocate an amount of inventory that you want to send to Shopify. So if I go to inventory, we'll take a look at one of my items. Under locations now, I can check this box to say that I want to track inventory in Shopify and then allocate a certain amount of my inventory items to be sold in Shopify. And then we'll count down those items and it will not let you sell what you don't have. So that's a quick overview of what's coming in AccountEdge version 2015, and we'll have videos coming up in the next few days that go into each of those features in much more detail, and I hope you like them.